हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अनदर पॉइंट दैट इज द सीक्रेशन ऑफ ओवेरियन हार्मोन इन द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। सीक्रेशन ऑफ द ओवेरियन हार्मोन, नाउ यू लुक, दिस इज अ ओवरी। ओवरी, आई थिंक यू नो द ओवरी इज अ फीमेल गोनाड। It is a female reproductive organ. It is hormone shaped, one pair, and located in the abdominal cavity. It is a primary sexual organ in female, and it secretes hormone. That's why it is a endocrine. I think you know the luteinizing hormone and follicle cell stimulating hormone released by pituitary gland by action of hypothalamus, or other word, due to the hypothalamus, the pituitary gland is stimulated and pituitary gland releases two hormones, that is LH and FSH. Now this LH and FSH activate thecal cell and granulosa cell of secondary follicle. Now you look this diagram. This is a primordial follicle which is converted into primary follicle, and primary follicle converted into secondary follicle. So those are the strong primary follicle, then it is converted into secondary follicle. So in the secondary follicle, the thecal cell of secondary follicle and granulosa cell of secondary follicle, they are responsible for secretion of the hormone. Now the thecal cell are stimulated and increase absorption of more cholesterol. And I think you know the cholesterol is a precursor of synthesis of steroid hormone. Generally, mitochondrial enzyme which are present in the ovarian cell which absorb more cholesterol, and this cholesterol is a precursor of steroid hormone. Now ovary, especially thecal cell and granulosa cell of secondary follicle, release two hormones such as estrogen and progesterone. So now these two hormones are very important, which is released from ovary, and these two hormones we call as a steroid hormone, that is the estrogen and progesterone. Now these two hormones or steroid hormone, I just mentioned here, the progesterone act by enzyme to form androgen. If the thecal cell of secondary follicle do not have enzyme aromatase, then thecal cell do not produce estrogen. I think you already discussed in the steroidogenesis. So progesterone act by enzyme to form androgen. If the thecal cell of secondary follicle do not have enzyme aromatase, then thecal cell do not produce estrogen. When aromatase enzyme is present, then androgen is diffused in the granulosa cell and produce estrogen. Now this estrogen diffused in the blood, estrogen is produced by granulosa cell, is a feedback of hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Now we look the role of estrogen. This is a female hormone, this is a steroid hormone, and this is a very important hormone. Generally, there are three types of the estrogen which is released from ovary, that is the estradiol. First is estradiol, second is estrone, and third is estrone. So especially estradiol, that is estrogen, is responsible for development of secondary sexual organ. Means this hormone is responsible, estrogen is responsible for development of secondary sexual organ. Now, it is also responsible for development of secondary sexual character at the age of puberty, such as increased pitch of sound in female. That means the sound of female is changes and increase the pitch of sound in female. Development and growth of mammary gland, and it control sexual behavior in female. This is the role of estrogen. Now we look at the second hormone, that is the progesterone. I think you know the ovulation. This is occurs at the day of 14 in the menstrual cycle. So in the ovulation, the release of ovum by rupturing graafian follicle or mature follicle and release ovum. Now the empty cell is remaining. And this empty cell, it is a colored body. It is called as a corpus luteum. Now this hormone, progesterone, is responsible for growth of alveoli in the mammary gland. And this is also responsible in the secretion of milk in the mammary gland. So empty follicle, that is the corpus luteum, it is a yellow colored body, and this corpus luteum is responsible for secretion of progesterone hormone. And now this progesterone hormone, it is responsible for growth of alveoli in the mammary gland and secretion of milk in the mammary gland. This hormone maintain pregnancy up to the 9 month. Therefore, this hormone, it is called as a pregnancy hormone. If this hormone is a decline, if the level of this hormone is reduced or decline during pregnancy, then it causes abortion. Therefore, this hormone, it is called as an anti-abortion hormone. It is also called as a thermogenic hormone because it increases body temperature. Okay.